In 1848, Phineas Gage, an American railroad construction worker, suffered a traumatic brain injury when an iron rod was driven through his entire skull, destroying much of his frontal lobe. Gage miraculously survived, but post-accident reports described him as a changed man, stating that the injury had transformed him into an unpleasant, aggressive drunkard, suggesting that specific brain regions were important for certain functions. This idea grew stronger over the years after studies showed that specific parts of the brain were in fact dedicated to specific parts of personality and behavior. In ancient Greece, Aristotle thought that the brain was responsible for cooling down blood like a radiator, and the heart is where the thoughts really take place. It wasn't until the 1800s when we finally found that there were actual cells making up the matter of the brain that now we call nerve cells. Humans have always been a curious species, and it is this curiosity that has driven the expansion of technology that now allows us to look inside a living human brain and study its functions and inner workings based on images. If we were to unfold the human brain, it would take up approximately 1 square meter. An adult human brain weighs about 1.5 kilograms, making up less than 2% of a human body's weight. But it is this 2% that defines our humanity and makes us who we are. It is responsible for generations of thought, language, attention, consciousness, memory, imagination, and whatnot. Perhaps the most impressive feature of the brain are the amount of connections that form between its nerve cells, known as neurons. The best suitable analogy would be to compare the brain with the Milky Way. There are an estimated 86 billion neurons in the brain, just like the billions of stars in the galaxy, resulting in between 100 to 500 trillion neural connections within the brain. When you unknowingly touch a hot surface, you immediately pull back your hand. It's one of the many reflexes we have during a day. Pretty normal stuff, right? Now, let's get behind the brain to understand how it coordinates with our muscles to provide us that reflex. The receptors present in the fingers sense the heat from the kettle. The sensory nerves in the fingers absorb this impulse and transmit it to the spinal cord. And from the spinal cord, this impulse passes to the motor neurons, which in turn passes this impulse to the affected muscle, which causes you to immediately remove your hand from the hot surface. This whole process takes place in less than a fraction of a second, involving coordination among millions of nerve cells known as neurons. The largest part of our brain is the cerebrum, also known as the cerebral cortex. It integrates information from our sense organs like the skin, nose, ears, or eyes, and initiates motor functions, controls emotions, and holds memory and thought processes. Underneath the cerebral cortex lies the brainstem, which is responsible for vital life functions such as breathing, heartbeat, and blood pressure. The cerebellum, which sits on the top of the brainstem, is associated with regulation and coordination of movement, posture, and balance. For example, when you learn to ride a bicycle or play the guitar, it's the cerebellum which plays the most significant role in helping your body acquire the movements between the various limbs that need specific actions associated with riding a bicycle or learning a guitar. The basic building block of the brain is a nerve cell called neuron. Everything that you do or say or even think about doing or saying is because of these neurons. Neurons make billions of connections every second between themselves to carry information in and out of the brain according to the requirement of our body. A neuron consists of a celled body called soma with several thin threads like extensions from the cell body called dendrites. The dendrites receive impulses from the adjoining neurons and with the help of the axon transmit specific information in the form of nerve impulses away from the cell body to other cells. Axons are like the whisperers inside the brain, passing gossip from one neuron to the next through a microscopic gap known as the synaptic gap. This gap is less than 40 nanometers wide. By comparison, a human hair is about 75,000 nanometers. When an information is passed down a neuron, it activates the chemical messengers that jump that tiny synaptic gap to deliver the message to its adjacent neuron. These messengers are called neurotransmitters. neurons communicate with neurotransmitters, which in turn cause motion and emotion. When a neuron gets just the right neurotransmitter at just the right time, it helps the brain concentrate, relax, shift attention, or create. But when neurotransmitters aren't able to do their job right, like when there are too many messengers or too few, the message is not understood correctly. The brain loses focus and gets tired, worries, or retreats from reality. For example, when a neurotransmitter called serotonin doesn't make it across the neuron, the brain makes the whole body sad and depressed. And we've got 100 different types of these neurotransmitters in our brain. Some of them make us feel good, like the endorphins we get flooded with after running 10 miles or falling in love, or even eating something sweet. Serotonin is often linked to mood, which comes from the understanding that many antidepressants cause serotonin levels to rise. Acetylcholine enables muscle action and influences learning and memory. Alzheimer's patients that lose their memory experience a lot of confusion in their daily life because of deterioration in their acetylcholine-producing neurons. Disorders like Parkinson's disease, due to which people struggle to walk, maintain balance, even talk and maintain coordination, is because of dopamine deficiencies. However, an attempt to define any neurotransmitter by one function is inevitably an oversimplification. Due to the vast complexity of the brain, much remains to be discovered. We are still a long way behind towards identifying the key differences in a vast array of unknown neurons. In the longer term, new treatments for devastating brain diseases are likely to emerge from a deeper understanding of brain circuits. The analysis of circuits is not the only area of neuroscience worthy of attention, but advances in technology are driving human capabilities to a completely new level. In our subsequent videos, we'll try to dive deeper into some of the most fascinating areas of research related to the mind, where science, philosophy, and psychology seem to converse at a single point to explain the greatest unknown, also known as the human brain. If you guys are new to the channel, then I do encourage you to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on our channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button below. We make content on a wide range of subjects, and you can even suggest us the topics you want us to cover in the comment section below.